Hi, my name is Zizhou Huang. I'm a PhD student from New York University, advised by Daniele Panozzo and Dennis Zorin. My thesis is titled Computational Shape Design Through Robust Physics Simulations. Computational shape design has wide applications, including mechanical structures, metamaterials, architectures, and soft robotics. A traditional pipeline starts from physics simulations and its differentiability. We can then run optimizations to minimize certain objectives, and the optimized shape is then fabricated. My thesis explores how we can improve each part of this pipeline. We propose a robust differentiable simulator and then apply it to help design microstructures that can be easily fabricated. One way of shape design is using microstructures. Previous works discretize the object into coarse voxel grid and perform simulations on the coarse grid. Eventually, they fill voxels with detailed microstructures after the optimization. However, this method is limited to square cells, which has poor geometry approximation. Therefore, we propose a special family of cells that can preserve the geometry surface. We show on a variety of models that we can well preserve the geometry surface with even coarse grids. However, due to the lack of collision handling, the structure intersects with itself under large deformation, which inspires us to develop a robust differentiable simulator to handle the collisions. A recent work called IPC, which is a physics simulator that can handle collisions, guarantees stability and intersection-free. We developed a differentiable simulator based on IPC to handle the collisions. With various optimization examples included, we support differentiability with respect to all the physics parameters involved. We integrated our work into PolyFEM, which is an open-source finite element library, and our work has been shown useful in multiple publications on computational design and robotics. It is useful in various applications and accurate enough to match the reality in fabrication. Now we can design microstructures that undergo large deformations and have complex contacts. Shock absorbers appear widely in our daily life. We performed shape design to create microstructures for shock absorbers and generated a family of microstructures with varying topology and stiffness to serve a range of applications. The optimized microstructure can then be tiled to wrap delicate objects and protect them. The microstructure undergoes extremely large deformation and complex contact, which is handled robustly by our differentiable simulator. We also fabricated the results and validated that the simulation matches closely with the experiments, and used it to protect a Christmas ball. To summarize, my thesis developed a robust differentiable simulator and used it to extend the microstructure design to a new level. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Yong Li from George Mason University. My advisor is Professor Utam Gingold. The title of my thesis is Domain-Specific Languages for Geometry Processing. As a PhD student, we often need to evaluate a paper. We read the paper over and find the formula. For this example, we may first implement it by C++. During implementation, it's easy to create bugs that we may never notice. For example, MI should be MG here. Later on, we may switch to Python and need to re-implement the same formula again. In general, it's inconvenient to maintain the consistency here, especially when the formula itself has typos sometimes. My PhD thesis is to make the whole process from writing the paper to implementing the formula easier. I published 3 papers during my PhD. The first one is AHAT-LA. AHAT-LA is a language with a syntax designed to closely mimic a conventionally written linear algebra, while still ensuring an unambiguous compilable interpretation. AHAT-LA allows users to write linear algebra in text form and compile the same source into LaTeX, C++ with Eigen, Python with NumPy, SciPy, and MATLAB. To motivate our decisions, we analyzed all numbered equations from all technical papers published at SIGGRAPH 2019. Here is the overview of them. We evaluated AHAT-LA on a variety of examples from different papers, books, and online courses. After AHAT-LA, I developed another tool called HATDown. HATDown is an environment for reading and writing scientific documents. Instead of writing formulas in LaTeX, you write them in AHAT-LA. By compiling the math, Hadang augments the paper with clickable definitions and warns you when you've forgotten to describe a variable. The compiled mess can be used to generate figures. Updating the formula will change both the mess output and the figure. We converted a variety of SIGGRAPH papers and paper sections to Hadang. My third work is AHADMesh. AHADMesh is a DSL designed for mesh processing, which resembles notation commonly used in visual and geometric computing, automating the process of converting notation into code. The centerpiece of our language is a flexible notation for specifying and manipulating neighborhoods of a cell complex, internally represented via standard operations on sparse boundary matrices. We can rapidly implement various algorithms on point clouds, surface meshes, and volume meshes. In conclusion, the three tools I've built can make the whole process from writing the paper to implementing the formula easier.
Hi, my name is Mikey Fischer. I'm a fourth-year PhD student at University College London. My thesis research is focused on intelligent optimization and inverse rendering, where we are given a set of observations and want to recover the corresponding scene parameters. Here, an artist is taking a picture of a surface with their phone, and an algorithm produces the correct SVBRDF maps for the image. This process, however, is often non-trivial due to several problems to which my thesis develops solutions. In my first project, MetaPpearance, we tackled the problem of slow network convergence in inverse rendering. Usually, we train our appearance models via gradient descent, which uses many small steps to converge to a solution. Overfitting a network, therefore, can be a slow process and takes several hours. On the other hand, general inference networks are fast, as they only need a single forward pass, but often lack fine details. In MetaPpearance, we bridge this gap by introducing the MAML algorithm to the graphics community, where, similar to human learning, we build strong priors by learning from past experience. MetaPpearance learns to adapt the network initialization itself in order to accelerate subsequent learning procedures. This allows us to achieve overfitting quality at interactive speeds, which we show on textures, SVBRDFs, and even the light transport for an entire scene. In my second project, PRDPT, we look at a different reason that often hinders convergence of inverse rendering: plateaus in the cost landscape. These originate from the fact that inverse rendering usually works by computing per pixel differences in image space. Here, several parameter combinations can lead to the same loss value, effectively creating these plateaus where the gradient is zero and our optimization will get stuck. We propose to alleviate this by convolving the rendering equation with a Gaussian smoothing kernel, which effectively smooths out these plateaus and leads to smoother cost landscapes. We derive an efficient Monte Carlo estimator, an important sample for this new path space, and show that our algorithm leads to improved convergence and robustness for many inverse rendering scenarios. In my third project, ZeroGrads, we investigate how we can enable gradient-based optimization on arbitrary non-differentiable forward models where we don't have access to the cost landscape at all. The key idea here is that while we cannot directly access the gradient, we can sample the cost landscape at different positions by simply executing a non-differentiable forward model and computing the resulting loss value. With these samples, we can build a neural model of the cost landscape and use the analytically computable gradient of this model to drive our gradient descent. We show that ZeroGrad scales well to high dimensions and can be applied to many non-differentiable applications, including a renderer, 3D modeling tools, and an entire physics simulator. In summary, my thesis develops new angles on inverse rendering that enable efficient, plateau-reduced gradient descent on arbitrary forward models. In the future, I would like to explore whether we can use these methods to go beyond first-order gradient descent. Thank you for listening.
Hi, my name is Chuan Yan, and my thesis focuses on the human-centered and AI-based digital painting, which advised by Yutam Gingo in George Mason University. When human begins drawing from scratch, their mental model often follows a pattern like the design squiggle, which is a visual representation of the creative process, illustrating the messy, exploratory phases of design that eventually lead to a clarity and focused solution. Usually, this process begins chaotically, involving trial, error, and refinement before arriving at a final, polished outcome. The messiness and iteration are nature and essential parts of the design process. However, this process has not yet been fully understood or replicated by current digital painting tools. They only tend to treat artworks like general image types as photos, which creating two major limitations: low efficiency and high demands when using traditional tools, and reduce the quality and controllability when using AI-based tools. As a result, artists are hindered from effectively utilizing these technologies. My research aims to bridge this gap by adopting human-centric approaches, improving digital painting technologies to better understand and process drawings from the perspective of how artists think and create. We begin by studying a key stage in this process, sketch cleanup. To support this, we develop a sketch cleanup dataset, uncovering key attributes of the sketches. Firstly, separate stroke based on its types, and conducted a comprehensive benchmark of state-of-the-art methods. This analysis allowed me to propose new directions that align how humans perceive and refine the drawings, laying the groundwork for more precise digital painting tools. Building on these insights, we tackled the challenge of converting complex sketches into vector form. By framing vectorization as a surface extraction problem, I chose the unsigned descent field as the intermediate representation and used dual contouring to reconstruct the vector lines. Our methods achieved state-of-the-art results in handling intricate details like strokes and junctions, providing a strong foundation for downstream sketch processing applications. While examining later stages of this design process, we identified a step called flatting in the comic production workflow. This stage is particularly suited for AI-driven automation due to its time-consuming and tedious nature. In response, we developed a tool called Flat Magic. Flat Magic predicts and controls flat regions using simplified line drawings that represent only the boundary of those regions. By leveraging this intermediate representation, our tool significantly reduced the workload during the flatting process, allowing for easy control of the flatting outcome, and maintains professional quality. To sum up, on one hand, my research focused on developing sketch processing methods using representations beyond just pixels, laying the groundwork for future studies on visual abstraction, creativity, and expressiveness. On another hand, my research demonstrates the potential to improve professional artists' efficiency while maintaining the quality and control of their work. Moving forward, we aim to develop more tools that better align AI with the human creative process.
Character modeling has come a long way, from the earliest low-poly characters to modern modeling techniques, thanks in no small part to performance capture. Performance capture is able to faithfully reproduce realistic skin textures. Unfortunately, it cannot always be used. What if you need a fantastic creature, don't have the right actor available, or need to create an army? It would be good if we could generate biologically plausible textures, which is what we've been doing in this thesis. This is no small task and requires a lot of interlocking parts. First and foremost, a light scattering model of light through skin. For this we use Baranowski's BioSpec model. It works by stretching a cross-section of skin to an infinite plane, and then scattering different wavelengths of light through each layer. With this we can capture a faithful BRDF of skin under biological parameters. These are parameters such as the thickness and bulk scattering of layers, or the concentration of pigments that give skin a specific color. Next, we need models for each of the prominent tissues in skin. The most prominent feature of the skin surface are the skin wrinkles. We present a model that's able to recognize and trace wrinkles in photographs, which can then be used to render new height maps. Next, we present a model for generating melanocyte distributions. For this, we estimate melanin concentrations from the ISIC database. We can use these to generate new distributions of melanocytes within the texture. For the blood vessels in skin, we created a biologically plausible model for vascular growth that allows blood vessel networks to be grown interactively within a mesh. These can then be projected onto the mesh surface to be rendered out in UV space. This system also allows for dynamic changes in blood flow during animation, such as the evacuation of blood when pressure is applied. For skin features smaller than a pixel, we estimate noise parameters from scans. We also generate pores that are placed into the texture in a blue noise pattern. Each of these models generates distributions of biological parameters that are combined. We also show how to do this conversion in real time using a lookup table. which can also be used to generate a wide spectrum of skin texture variants. Last but not least, we'll show how to get the models into your render engine by providing a general method to convert BRDS from one model to another, which allows BioSpec to be converted to a model your engine supports. This way we're able to generate skin textures for handcrafted or generated meshes.
Hello, I'm Ningna, a PhD student at the University of Texas in Dallas. My research focuses on computing 3D media axis transform via the restricted power diagram, RPD. The media axis is a type of skeleton. It consists of the centers of maximum inscribed spheres, often called media spheres. Each of them touches the surface at least two tangent points. The set of these sphere centers and their radii is known as the media axis transform, MAT. There are many applications of media axis, such as 3D object segmentation, collision detection, image reconstruction, hexahedral meshing, plant methods, and 3D shape synthesis. However, previous methods only focus on organic shapes, and they're not able to compute high-quality MAT for CAD models. These methods cannot preserve any external features, such as sharp edges and corners. PC and ICT also struggle with topology correctness, whose Euler characteristic is not consistent with the input. On the other side, VC requires a large amount of media spheres in order to preserve the homotopy equivalent. To generate high-quality media mesh for both CAD models and organic shapes, my PhD research focuses on addressing three key challenges: how to preserve media features, ensure topology equivalence, and maintain geometric accuracy using the least number of media spheres. My research addresses these challenges using the restricted power diagram, RPD. The RPD provides a natural decomposition of the shape based on the media spheres. The dual of the RPD also provides a connectivity. The intuition of preserving media features is to sample as many media spheres as needed. To preserve external features, we sample more zero radius media spheres near sharp edges. For internal features, we detect areas where internal feature spheres are lacking and sample more accordingly. For topology preservation, according to the nerve theorem, for any shape with no cavity, we test the two topological indicators for each restricted element of RPD, the number of connected components and the Euler characteristic. And we're expecting the value of these two indicators all equal to 1. If the test fails, we apply refinement by adding new media spheres in the local region. To achieve geometric accuracy, we need to update protruded media spheres to be tangent to the surface. Our optimization strategy consists of two stages. First, we lock the existing tangent point and update the sphere according to a quadratic energy function. Then, we fix the sphere and update the tangent point. In conclusion, my PhD research presents a complete RPD-based framework for computing the 3D media axis transform, preserving media features, topology, and geometric accuracy. In the future, we hope to explore more properties of the media axis, like structural awareness for shape segmentation. Thank you.